come into my heart. Come and fill me, O Lord. Come and fill me, O Lord. Come into me, O Lord. Come and fill me. Fill me with your power. Fill me with your strength. Oh, Holy Spirit, come into my mind. Come into my soul. Come into my soul. Come and fill me. Fill me, O Lord. Fill me, O Lord. Fill me with the power, fill me with the holiness. Oh, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, come on, fill me, O Lord. Come on, fill me. Come on, dwell in me, O Holy Spirit. Come on, dwell in me, O Lord. I am your temple. Come on, dwell in me, O Holy Spirit. Dwell in me. And make me holy, O Holy Spirit. I want to be yours. I want to be in holiness. I want to serve the Lord. I want to be His witness. O Holy Spirit, empower me. Strengthen me, O Lord. Make me so powerful. Give me your grace. Give me your gifts. And empower me, O Holy Spirit. Give me the grace to be with you every time. Oh, I ask you, Lord, to give me the grace to keep the word, to lead a holy life. I ask you, Holy Spirit.
Your right hand, keep it straight to the Lord. I'm going to ask the Holy Spirit to give you the gift of strong faith. Not a normal faith, you need strong faith. Whatever things comes against you, that should not lose your faith. That you should not lose your faith in the Lord. He should be the rock in you. And He is your fortress. Let you have strong faith in the name of Jesus Christ in your heart. Praise you. Hallelujah, glory. Straighten your right hand to the Lord. May the power of the Holy Spirit flow into you through your right hand. Hallelujah, glory. Come, Holy Spirit. Let your power flow into me through my right hand. I ask for your power, Holy Spirit. Who comes to the Heavenly Father? Fill me with the power, the courage and boldness. Give me strong faith. Give me the grace of strong faith. Strong faith. Strong faith. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Every spirit of fear, I rebuke you. Your spirit of doubt, I rebuke you. I bind and rebuke you in the name of Jesus Christ. Go! In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Close your eyes. I just said this word, yes. When you hear this word, yes, immediately you keep your right hand on your forehead. With the force, with the power. Now your right hand is filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. The fire is flowing. Receive it. Yes! Keeping your hand on it, follow your, praise the Lord. Thank Him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory.
Book of Matthew, chapter 15, verse 21. Jesus left that place and went away to the district of Tyre and Sidon. Just then a Canaanite woman from that region came out and started shouting, "Have mercy on me, Lord. Son of David, my daughter is tormented by a demon."
संपत्ति का सुसमाचार 15वां अध्याय 21वां वचन। ईसा ने वहां से विदा होकर तीरुस और सिदोन प्रांतों में प्रवेश प्रस्थान के लिए प्रस्थान किया। उस समय उस प्रदेश की कनानी स्त्री आई और पुकार पुकार कर कहती रही, प्रभु दाऊद के पुत्र, मुझ पर दया कीजिए, मेरी बेटी एक अपदूत द्वारा बुरी तरह से सताई जा रही है।
A Gentile woman, a Canaanite woman, she's Gentile. She's crying and she's coming by after Jesus, saying that, "Jesus, have mercy on me, Lord."
Son of David, my daughter is tormented by a demon.
एक गैर यहूदी स्त्री, जो यहूदी नहीं है, प्रभु पर विश्वास, वो प्रभु उस वो इसराइली नहीं है, और वो आकर उनसे कह रही है कि हे प्रभु दाऊद के पुत्र, मेरी पुत्री पर दया कीजिए जिसको एक अपदूत सता रहा है।
But he did not answer her at all.
लेकिन ईसा ने उसके सवाल का कोई जवाब नहीं दिया।
And his disciples came and urged him, "Send her away. For she keeps shouting after us."
उनके शिष्यों ने उनके पास आकर कहा कि उसकी बात मानकर उसे विदा कीजिए।
See, a mother, she's crying from her heart to the Lord. My daughter is being tormented by the demon. Have mercy on me, O Lord, and heal my child. She's crying and she is walking after Jesus. The Jesus with the disciples were walking. This woman also is moving with them. Jesus, how mercy on me? How mercy on me, Jesus? Heal my daughter. She is being tormented by devil. This is what she is crying for many time. She is with the Lord, but Jesus, did he notice her? He just walked like this.
एक माँ का बेसहारापन जरा देखिए। उसकी बेटी अपदू से हमेशा सताई जा रही है, वो यीशु से बार बार बोल रही है कि मेरे बच्ची पर दया कीजिए, लेकिन यीशु उसकी बिल्कुल भी नहीं सुन रहे हैं, वो अपने रास्ते आगे बढ़ते जा रहे हैं।
Why Jesus didn't answer her?
यीशु ने उनको जवाब क्यों नहीं दिया?
See, many times when we do our prayer, we are crying and praying to the Lord for his mercy, but we may not get any answer for some days, for some months, may not be no answer at all. Then the next step we take is that we will start to blame God. What, Jesus, this much I prayed and cried, he's not responding to me. Why is he torn? Why he's so hard? His heart is so hard. We start to blame God. No need of praying. There is no use of prayer. So this will be the comments that we make. Many times Jesus will do this in our life. That he did in the life of that Canaanite woman. She was crying. See, this thing is that, no, her daughter is being tormented by the devil. A devil is attacking the child. Immediately he should have said, "Okay, I will come and heal the child. I will cast out the demon." He's not even responding. A person possessed by the devil is not a simple thing. That is why that Canaanite woman crying to the Lord, "Lord, do something, heal my child, save my child." But he didn't heal. Notice at all. He just walked. And immediately the disciples, They urged Jesus, and his disciples came and urged him, saying, "Send her away, for she keeps shouting after us." Maybe Peter or Thomas or John came to Jesus, said to the Lord, "Send her away. She is crying and coming. It's a nuisance. Send her away, Lord." Because a woman is crying and coming after Jesus for a long time. They said to the Lord, "Send her away."
हमारे जीवन में जरूरतें आई, हमने प्रार्थना की 10 दिन 15 दिन, लेकिन उसका जवाब नहीं मिला। अगला चरण क्या है? हम तुरंत प्रभु को दोषी ठहराने लगते हैं कि इतने दिन हमने प्रार्थना किया लेकिन आपने हमारी नहीं सुनी। लेकिन यहाँ पर आप देखिए कि वो स्त्री, वो कनानी स्त्री आती है और वो लगातार यीशु के पीछे पड़ गई है, हाथ धोकर पड़ गई है कि मेरी बच्ची पर आप दया कीजिए। और शिष्यों को आखिरकार ये महसूस होने लगा कि ये औरत हमारे लिए मुसीबत बन रही है, इसे पीछा छुड़ाना चाहिए। इसीलिए वो लोग यीशु को कहते हैं कि इसको कुछ उत्तर दे के इसको विदा कीजिए, ये तो हमारे पीछे पड़ गई है।
हालेलुया। See, when the disciples said to Jesus, he said like this, "I was sent only for the lost children of Israel." He said, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." See, Jesus was so serious. He said, "I am sent only for the lost sheep of Israel."
जब शिष्यों के पास से यीशु ने ऐसी बात सुनी तो उन्होंने उसकी तरफ लगभग उससे मुंह फेर लिया और कहा, मैं केवल इसराइल की खोई हुई भेड़ों को ढूंढ कर लाने के लिए भेजा गया हूँ।
And the disciple who came to intercede for that lady, he just turned away.
और
because he may have felt that it is no use of telling Jesus. Because all this time this lady was crying and weeping and shouting for the healing of her child. Even the disciples may be thinking, why he is not taking care of the lady? They have never seen such an incident in the life of Jesus Christ. Every time, whenever someone comes and cry, he used to heal them or deliver them. But here, he is not even taking care of that lady, not attending that lady. And when the disciple is interceding to the Lord, he said so seriously, "I am sent only for the lost sheep of Israel, not for these people." It was so serious, and the disciple thought, no use of telling. But see, that lady, she came and knelt before him, saying, "Lord, help me." This is very important. The disciples, even they couldn't help that lady. She came forward. Means she came, it's okay, aage aaya. She came to the in front of Jesus. She knelt down, holding his feet. She cried out, "Lord, have mercy on me." She cried from her heart. She cried from her heart, "Lord, have mercy on me. Help me." He answered, "It is not fair to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs." Oh. It is not fair to take the children's food. See, the Lord, he is the Lord, he is God. He says that it is not good to take the children's food. That means he was sent to heal, to help the Jewish people, the chosen race. They are children of God. That is why he said, "I am sent only for those sheep in Israel." She is not Israelite. She is a Gentile. He says that it is not good, it is not fair to take children's food and throw it to the dogs. Oh, who is dog here? She is the state of a dog, that Canaanite woman. See, we may think, why the Lord use such a word? Suppose I tell you, if you come to me, I tell you, I am not supposed to do my help to the dogs. What do you feel? That means indirectly I was calling you as dog. Isn't it? I was telling you are a dog.
That is what Jesus said. It is not right. It is not good. The children's food and give it to the dogs. Oh, what will be the condition of the lady? But she didn't leave. It's very wonderful. And she said, "Yes, Lord. Yet even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table." Hallelujah. The lady says to the Lord, "Yes, Lord, I know I am a dog. But even the dogs eat the crumbs, the parts of food that fall from their master's table." What great faith. Jesus dismissed her. You didn't belong to my group of people, my children. You are in the possession of a dog. What words he used. Still that lady didn't go back. She held his feet tightly and cried, "How mercy on me, help me." The reason, you know, she knows very well Jesus can heal. And only he can do that. No one else in this world can deliver that child from that bondage. She knew very well only Jesus can do it. So she had that great faith in her. And she knew very well that she may have done magic and witchcraft, many, many things to heal that child before. Everything failed. Many came to heal that girl. Everything failed. And now she knew very well that this is my last hope. If I lose this, there will be no chance. So she was not ready to lose it. She is holding the feet of Jesus. She is not allowing the Lord to move. She knelt down and cried, "How mercy on me. I know I'm a dog, but these dogs eat the crumbs that fall from the master's table." Hearing her reply, Jesus answered her, "Woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And her daughter was healed instantly. Let us give the Lord a mighty hand of praise. Hallelujah. See, Jesus said to that lady, "Your faith is so strong." Jesus answered her, "Woman, great is your faith." Great is your faith. Today the Lord is expecting such a faith from us. We need that great faith in us. Let him reject us. Let the Lord reject our prayers. You have to say, "No, I won't leave. I won't leave till I get an answer for this. Till I get the blessing from you, I won't leave. I won't stop my prayer. I am forcing the Lord, do it, do it, do it through my prayer, through your prayer. You have to force the Lord. Compel him to do it for you. Because you know you are in need of that. You need it in your life. Without it, you can't go forward. You can't survive. Whatever it is, maybe the healing of your healing or your parents' healing, whatever it is, insist the Lord. Compel him to do it. First, he may reject your prayer. Lord will wait for you. He will wait and see how much faith you have in your heart.
यीशु जब कहते हैं कि मैं इसराइल के घराने की खोई हुई भेड़ों के को ढूंढने के लिए मैं भेजा गया हूँ, यीशु के पास से ऐसा रूखा जवाब सुनकर हो सकता है शिष्यों ने भी अपने कंधे उचका दिए कि अब प्रभु से कुछ बोलने का ज़रूरत नहीं है, फ़ायदा नहीं है। लेकिन यहाँ पर ये हमको देखने को मिलता है कि यीशु जवाब नहीं दे रहे हैं, ये देखने के बावजूद 25वां वचन, वो स्त्री आकर यीशु के सामने सिर डाल के वो प्रणाम करती है और उनका रास्ता रोकती है। वो अच्छी तरह से जानती है यही वो मौका है जब मैं इस व्यक्ति से मिल सकती हूँ। हो सकता है इससे पहले वो अपने बच्ची के लिए ओझाओं के पास में गई, जादू टोना करवाया, सब कुछ किया, झाड़ फूंक करवाया, लेकिन लेकिन कोई फायदा नहीं हुआ। लेकिन उसने सुना है, उसने देखा भी होगा कि इस व्यक्ति के पास में शक्ति है और वो अपदूतों को मुक्ति दे सकता है, और इसी विश्वास की वजह से वो हाथ में आया हुआ ये मौका छोड़ना नहीं चाहती है। वो उनके रास्ता रोक कर वो सिर झुका के पड़ जाती है कि प्रभु मेरे लिए कुछ कीजिए। और उस समय यीशु कहते हैं, बच्चों की रोटी लेकर कुत्ते के पिल्लों के सामने डालना ठीक नहीं है। उसके बहिष्कार का तो सीमा लांग गया। उस दूसरे शब्दों में हम देख सकते हैं, यीशु ने तो उस औरत को कुत्ते का नाम दे दिया, लेकिन वो औरत फिर भी हिम्मत नहीं हारती है, क्योंकि उसको मालूम है यही वो व्यक्ति है जो मेरी बच्ची को पूरी तरह से चंगाई दे सकता है। और वो माँ का हृदय टूटता है और वो फिर भी गहरे विश्वास के साथ में प्रभु के साथ में जुड़कर खड़ी रहती है और बोलती है, हाँ प्रभु, मैं कुत्ता का पिल्ला हूँ, तो भी कुत्ते के पिल्ले तो मेज पर से मालिक का गिरा हुआ खाने का चूरा भी खा लेते हैं, तो उसका मतलब है कि मुझे पूरा खाना नहीं चाहिए, मुझे थोड़ा सा चूरा जैसा खाना भी दे दीजिए, लेकिन दीजिए। और यीशु का मन पूरी तरह से डवाडोल हो गया। यीशु इतना आत्मा में आनंदित हो गए और उन्होंने उस स्त्री को जवाब दिया। 28वां वचन, नारी तुम्हारा विश्वास महान है, तुम्हारी इच्छा पूरी हो। और यीशु उसके विश्वास के आधार पर उसके बच्ची के ऊपर यीशु की दया आ जाती है।
हालेलुया,
हालेलुया।
एंड रिमेंबर, व्हेन यू प्रे, डोंट थिंक दैट लॉर्ड इज नॉट हियरिंग योर प्रेयर। मेक श्योर द लॉर्ड इज हियरिंग ऑल योर प्रेयर्स एवरी टाइम।
जब प्रार्थना करते हैं, इस बात का जरूर ध्यान रखिए, आपकी प्रार्थना आपके मन का दर्द व्यर्थ में नहीं जा रहा है। प्रभु आपका हर वचन सुन रहे हैं, हर प्रार्थना सुन रहे हैं।
When the Canaanite woman cried, first we heard that Jesus even he didn't notice at all, was just walking, but he is hearing her cries. He knew very well how much she is suffering. He knew very well, but he didn't respond. He was waiting to see her faith. When we pray, the Lord will be waiting for us to test our faith in us. So do not give up your prayers. Pray continuously.
वो औरत का रोना चिल्लाना प्रभु सुन रहे हैं, लेकिन वो उसे मुंह मोड़कर खड़े हैं। इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि वो औरत को पूरी तरह से वो बहिष्कार कर रहे हैं, सुन रहे हैं लेकिन वहीं खड़े हैं। ऐसे में हमको ये समझना चाहिए, हमारी प्रार्थना जो हम प्रभु को दे रहे हैं उससे प्रभु उसको बहिष्कार नहीं कर रहे हैं, वो सुन रहे हैं, लेकिन वो हमारे विश्वास की गहराई आंकना चाहते हैं।
You may be in need of purification of your heart. The purification of your heart, the God is expecting some purification from you.
Dusri baat, aapke prarthna ki sunwai hone ke liye ye karan ho sakta hai ki aapke hriday ke pavitrikaran ki zarurat ho.
The more you pray, the more you get purification.
Jitna zyada aap prarthna karenge, utni zyada aapke hriday ki pavitrata
badhegi. The more you pray, the more you come closer to the Lord.
Jitna zyada prarthna karoge, utna zyada aap prabhu ke kareeb aayenge.
The more you pray, the more you get the love of God in your life.
Jitna zyada prarthna karoge, utna zyada prabhu ka prem aap mein bhar jayega.
All your prayers are heard by the Lord. Do not think that God is not there and not hearing my prayers. All your prayers are heard, but he is expecting some purification from you through this suffering. God is not there, he is not hearing me, he is not loving me, he is not taking care of me. Don't blame God, never do that. But you have to realize that he is there, he is very near to you, hearing your prayers, seeing your suffering. He is there to support you, to help you. He never abandon you, he never leave you.
इसलिए इस बात को समझ जाइए कि आपकी प्रार्थनाओं का यदि तुरंत जवाब नहीं मिल रहा है, उसका कोई एक कारण है। हो सकता है आपके हृदय की पवित्रीकरण पूरी तरह से वो पूरे सतह पर नहीं पहुंचा हो, इसीलिए उसका प्रभु इंतज़ार कर रहे हो। आपका विश्वास कितना है ये देखने का प्रभु इंतज़ार कर रहे हो। इसीलिए मैं कहूँगा, अपने प्रार्थना को आप रुकाइए मत, बल्कि उसको लगातार आप करते जाइए।
हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू प्रे टू द सेंट्स?
आप में से कितने लोग संतों से मध्यस्थी पूछते हैं?
How many of you pray to the saints? to get blessings from God. Okay, many of you used to pray to saints. Actually, why you pray to the saints? Here we read that he heard that when the disciples came to intercede for that lady, Jesus didn't take care of that. They asked the Lord to send her away, but he didn't reply. They tried to support her, but Jesus was not willing to hear their plea, their request. Again he kept silence. Remember, my dear brothers and sisters, the Lord is willing from us. We have to come directly to him. We need saints. I'm not against saints, but we need that direct contact with God, with Jesus Christ. That is what the Lord is expecting from us. So Jesus was doing it with the lady. By rejecting the plea of the disciples, he gave that ability to the lady to open her heart to the Lord directly, and that helped him to heal that lady. Whenever we pray, many people go to Novena, go to Mahim Church. That is what they want. It's good, not wrong. But without the word, without loving Jesus, the saints are helpless many times in your life. But you come to the Lord, you come to the Lord directly, love him, pray to him. Why you go to the saints? Because due to the lack of faith in you in the Lord. If you have strong faith in the Lord, you will go directly to him. If your children have the faith in his heart that daddy will love him and help him, he will go directly to the daddy. And if he is frightened of the daddy, what do you do? You go to the mom. So he is forcing the mom to intercede for him to the daddy. So that is what we do. Realize that God is there. He loves everyone. He is longing for our love. He is waiting to hear from us. It is to increase our faith, not to abandon us. We have to increase our faith. Lord is waiting for that. So don't give up your prayers. Whatever it is, pray to the Lord till you get it.
मैं देखता हूँ आप में से कई लोग संतों से मध्यस्थी पूछते हैं नौर उनके नाम पर नौरोज की प्रार्थनाएं करते हैं. ये अच्छी बात है, लेकिन कई बार संतों का भी आपको सहायता मिलता नहीं है. कनानी स्त्री के इस अध्याय में हम इस घटना में हम ये देखते हैं कि यीशु का नाम लेकर पुकारने के बावजूद यीशु जब उसकी अनसुनी करते हैं तो शिष्य आकर यीशु से कहते हैं प्रभु उसको कोई जवाब देकर उसको छोड़िए, लेकिन यीशु उनकी तरफ से भी उनको भी वो हामी में जवाब नहीं देते हैं. यहाँ पर हमको ये समझना चाहिए कि हमारे विश्वास नहीं होने के वजह से, हमारे हृदय की पवित्रता नहीं होने के वजह से कई बार हम संत भी हमको मदद करने में मजबूर हो जाते हैं. हमको हमारा एक पिता है, पिता से हम क्यों ना सीधे हम प्रभु से प्रार्थना करें. विश्वास हमारा यदि उतना गहरा है तो हम सीधे प्रभु के पास में जाकर अपनी ज़रूरत पूरी कर सकते हैं. उदाहरण के तौर पर एक बच्चे को यदि अपने पिता से डर है, पिता के पास जाने से वो घबराता है, तो वो पहले क्या करेगा? पिता के पास सीधे ना जाके माँ से होकर वो पिता की तरफ जाएगा. हमारा एक पिता है, वो हमसे प्यार करते हैं, उनको हमारे प्यार की ज़रूरत है, वो हमारी प्रार्थना सुनने के लिए तैयार होकर बैठे हैं. आइए हम उन्हीं के पास सीधे चलें, पूरे विश्वास और पवित्रता से उन्हीं से याचना करें.
ज्ञानदायिनी मां मरियम.